Hello and welcome back to Supergirl Season 2, Episode 16. My name is Walter, and this episode is called, I'm not really sure. I'm just checking now. Oh, it's called Distant Sun. Oh, or is it Starcrossed? It's Starcrossed. I'm sorry. Anyway, before I start this, I just want to bring up something, because somebody actually commented that I didn't need to bring up I was Asian for Samurai Jack, and I'm like, dude, I'm proud I'm Asian, and I want to bring up the fact that I'm Asian because I'm proud to see heritage like myself and my culture on the big screen. Obviously, I'm not the same type cut of Asian that's being portrayed in Samurai Jack, because that's more Japanese and more anime, but I just want to show how proud I am, and to see an American animator, you know, like Genndy Tartakovsky, and of course others as well who has done it before, like Brian Konietzky and Michael, who did Avatar The Last Airbender, and that was my type of cut, which was Asian Chinese, more of an Asian Chinese. So I'm sorry if I'm proud and brought that up, but you know what, I'm still gonna bring it up because I love to talk about those things. Anyway, I don't really remember what happened in the last episode, so we're just gonna go in this really blind, so let's go. And by the way, somebody asked me to do this as well, so it's gonna be another React on Demand. So yeah, if you guys want me to watch any series, there's an Iron Fist series that's going on, but I've watched a few episodes of my own and it's quite boring, so I'm just gonna let you know that it's boring. So, and I guess maybe I'm kind of like, burnt out by superheroes already. Oh right, his parents are here, most probably. So they're gonna probably reveal Mona's true identity, which is, I'm definitely, you know, he's definitely a prince. It's a musical. Okay. If you're talking about recent times, I would actually suggest La La Land. Even though it has some cliches, you know. That is true, and it's getting meta too, guys. So, I mean, it's fair to criticize other people's stuff, but it's like, well, Manel, your time is up. lies. He's on a date with this girl. Oh. Yeah, no. I agree with him. It's like respectfully disagree. Oh, that probably is not the answer, 'cause that's a turret. Oh. That was probably a warning shot. And that's a shield, as expected. And she didn't watch out. I don't think you can do it. Even though you are the strongest woman alive, most probably. Okay, well, she did it. Kinda didn't expect that, to be honest with you. Because I thought that was like some other material that was in there, so. Oh, right, it's getting pretty interesting though, because it's like the people are after Monel. This is a goodbye. Most probably. Or is he still gonna stay for the long run? I'm not sure, because you know, I don't really know this actor's name. Oh yeah, he can't really fly. Well, she went with him. I told you they were his parents. Well, it's pretty obvious that they were his parents, 'cause they were alluding to this as well. It's probably true. Yeah, a prince. Wow, okay, that's pretty interesting as well. I think on the Superman storyline, because like there are intellectuals, intellectual beings as Kryptonians and some of them, you know, believe in they're polytheist, meaning they believe in a lot of gods. So that's pretty interesting. It's pretty nice seeing him on Cloud Nine, though. Looking at some art at nine. Dude, it wasn't him. She frame him. I mean, that's all dictators wanna enforce on them, right? Okay, now it's getting annoying. Because, like all things, I think like all shows are just like quoting the Donald Trump campaign trail, you know, make blank great again, and it's quite annoying, but with Gotham it made sense, because like Penguin is that kind of guy, but come on, this is the queen, you know? This looks like a Power Rangers set, though, if I'm being honest with you guys, because It looks like somewhere the Power Rangers would fight. That is really bad. Well, you know, it's hard when you have to tell somebody about your status, and it's royalty status, you know? Not a day in his life, blah blah blah, right? Well, he just said, of course, but I expected they were gonna go one more cliche. It's like, there's not a one a day. Yeah, that's true. She did. I'm gonna turn off the fan because, it's really cold in here. Sorry about being in the video frame. Well, you certainly have it to type. Okay, there's like something I want to talk about with Win, because like that's really something sad, because like I was like, he's supposed to be the guy who like is that goofy sidekick, but he really deserves someone. But it's just stupid that we have to have these type of cliches, you know? And I feel really sad for Rin. That is true. I think he's definitely guilty, because like he's... It's not like... It's always hard to be in the light of what your parents do, you know? Especially since if you're royalty. Aren't we all? Hamilton tickets, really? Pulling favors. Of course. That's true. What? What is that supposed to mean? What a bitch. Like, I'm sorry, but like, she's a bitch. I mean, that's true. Well, She's running away. And that's the whole trailer cut in half. Man, Gladiator pretty much is not as good as he wants to be. Like, he needs more training, if I'm gonna be honest with you. God, we're going for the double twist cliche. Shut up, Siri. Sorry, my Siri came on. This is the double twist cliche, which is like he thinks she's evil, but then she's evil because she's doing something good, blah blah blah, whatever. It's so stupid. Yeah, that's true. I mean, that's also true, because like well, I know what you're gonna do. Yep. Let her go and find the brother that she's talking about. There is Monel. Okay. Stop banging that nail into the table, Kara. We all know you don't get a chance to save your parents. So, okay, just stop. Because I'm pretty sick of it. And that's the alien guy. I'm pretty impressed by the makeup. Like, okay, hers is not so good, but the guys in the makeup is pretty alright. Like, with her, you can definitely know it's, makeup. It's mask and all that. Well, that's fair, you know? You can't fight a guy like that, bro. Come on. That's just a joke. That's definitely a voice modulator he's using. Because you can definitely hear the robotic. Well, why not? We've already had many cliches. Ugh, cheesy. Don't rub off the makeup. Okay. Leave. Is she even looking at you, bro? her eye just like went out of sight just now. Or is it just her contact? I don't know. Forgiveness. Well, seeing as how she's very angry about this, I don't think she's gonna think it's good enough for her, so. Another cheesy line, by the way. This is so cheesy, you guys. Like, I'm getting nauseous watching this part right now. Barf. What does it even mean? That's such a cliched line. And kiss. 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 Or break up. Up. Oh, it's a breakup. I saw that look. See? Told you guys. I love the song though. Sounds a bit like Florence and the Machine. And a bit like Birdie. I think it's a Birdie. I'm pretty sure it's Birdie. Not sure. Not that sure, but pretty sure. Confusing much. Mm-hmm. best thing. You can't ever get enough of these cliched lines, you know? Just one after another served to you on a platter of bullshit salads. It's going to deck them, isn't it? Oh, nope. What type of guest is he, though? Oh, it's Darren Chris. Is it Darren Chris? Yeah, it's pretty much Darren Chris, though, isn't it? Uh-oh. Oh no. What just happened, though? Okay. Nice decor, though. I'll sing something, though. I mean, you know, just go with the flow. Oh, to be continued on the Flash. Alright, strange ending, weird note to end on. Weird segue, too, to get into the Flash. That's something that is very, very strange, man. Like, usually they do it better. Like, this guy comes in and just, like, takes Cisco, or Wayne's device and Cisco's device as well, and teleports himself into the Flash's zone. So that's pretty weird, man. They've got to find a better way to do these storylines. And if it's gonna be the trio of Flash, Supergirl, Arrow again, I don't know, man, because I've been so out of Arrow, but I'm pretty sure it's probably the same. Because, you know, Oliver is that guy who's always in the dark and brooding, and he's the Batman of his own world. So, anyway, guys, that was pretty much it, and I'll see you guys next time on Flash. See you then.